Legendary music group The Temptations are regarded as one of the greatest American vocal groups to ever exist. Their impact on R&B and soul music is still popular today, and they had all the elements of what a supergroup could ask for. The Classic Five era of The Temptation members included Otis Williams, Eddie Kendricks, Melvin Franklin, David Ruffin, and Paul Williams. But this is a sad story about Paul Williams, who was the true soul of The Temptations. He had the style, he had the dance moves, and he had the voice. Paul Williams was born on July 2nd, 1939, in Birmingham, Alabama. He suffered from sickle cell anemia, which frequently wreaked havoc on his physical health. As a kid, he met fellow Temptations member Eddie Kendricks in elementary school. Supposedly, they had a fist fight after Paul dumped a bucket of mop water on Eddie. But nevertheless, they became best friends and shared a passion for singing, especially around town in the church in the late 1940s. Where they was from, there wasn't that many radio stations, so they were influenced by country, western, gospel, and R&B music. In 1955, Paul and Eddie, plus two other friends, formed a doo-wop group called The Cavaliers and began performing around Birmingham. After one of the members left the group, they became a trio and moved to Cleveland, Ohio, looking for more opportunities in the music industry. They ended up meeting Milton Jenkins, who became their manager, and he moved them to Detroit, Michigan, changing their names from The Cavaliers to The Primes. Now seeing some success with their new manager, they began to buzz in the Detroit area and eventually created a female spinoff group called The Primettes, which included Florence Ballard, Mary Wilson, and Diana Ross, who would later become The Supremes. In 1961, member Kel Osborne quit the group and moved to California, and The Primes broke up. Eddie Kendricks and Paul Williams returned to Alabama, but Eddie would always go back and visit family and friends in Detroit. While visiting family in Detroit, Eddie called Otis Williams, who was the leader of a rival Detroit group called The Distance, who needed two more members for his audition for Motown Records. Otis offered Eddie a lead singer position in his new group, but Eddie only agreed on the conditions he bring Paul Williams in with him. After Otis Williams happily agreed, they formed the group, The Temptations. Paul Williams would sing lead on the group's first two singles, titled Oh Mother of Mine and Check Yourself, and was considered the group's choreographer because he danced and dressed the best. During those days, Paul was the only one in the group who didn't drink. While the other Temptations was drinking during rehearsals, he was always drinking milk to stay healthy. In 1963, the Temptations began working with Smokey Robinson as producer and writer. Smokey's first song with the group was I Want a Love I Can See, with Paul Williams on lead vocals. The song failed the chart, and fans began to call the group the Hitless Temptations due to their lack of hits. After switching their lineup on lead vocals and pushing Paul to the background, the Temptations began producing hits such as The Way You Do the Things You Do with Eddie Kendricks on lead, and My Girl with David Ruffin singing his first lead vocal for the group, which became the Temptations' first number one pop hit in March 1965. Now, what was hidden from the public view was that Paul Williams suffered from sickle cell anemia, which often made it difficult for him to perform at times. The pain would make him depressed, and he began to drink heavily, developing a serious case of alcoholism. Now, like I said earlier, now Paul Williams had never consumed alcohol before. He was always drinking milk, but dealing with his sickness, he ended up drinking like 2 to 3/5 of Courvoisier a day. I mean, it got so bad that his stamina, his respiratory system started fading, and he began traveling with oxygen tanks. Now, group members did try to help him by draining out his alcohol stashes, because he would get too drunk and he couldn't remember the lyrics or stay on key. And after his health continued to decline to the point where he was unable to perform, He finally took a visit to a doctor in 1971, and a spot was found on his liver, and he was advised to retire. But the Temptations continued to pay Paul his same 1/5 share of the group's earnings and kept him on a payroll as an advisor and a choreographer. The Temptations, they had to hire Richard Street, lead singer of the Motown group The Monitors, to tour and sing with the group as a permanent replacement for Paul Williams. Paul also had serious financial problems. After he and Winnie Brown, the woman he was having an affair with, opened a celebrity fashion boutique in downtown Detroit was unsuccessful, he would end up owing more than $80,000 in taxes. Now in a deep depression, his childhood friend, Eddie Kendricks, convinced Motown that Paul Williams could make it as a solo artist. Eddie even wrote a song for him titled, Feel Like Giving Up, which Motown never got the chance to release because on August 17, 1973, Paul Williams was found dead in an alley in his car, having just left his new house with his girlfriend after an argument. His death was ruled a suicide from a self-inflicted gunshot wound to the head, but his family to this day suspect that there was foul play involved. According to the coroner, Paul Williams had used his right hand to shoot himself on the left side of his head. In addition to that, a bottle with alcohol was found near his left side, as if he had dropped it while being shot. The gun used in the shooting was found to have fired 2 rounds, but only 1 shot had killed Paul Williams. Now, Temptation members Otis Williams and Melvin Franklin claimed Paul expressed suicidal thoughts months before his death. Other members, Eddie Kendricks, had his doubts and said he had just seen Paul a couple days earlier and found him in a positive mood. David Ruffin said, why would Paul get into his car with only his underwear on, drive down a few blocks of Motown, and using his right hand shoot himself in the left side of his head? It don't make sense. After his death, his family sued Motown of not paying any royalties after he died, claiming he was owed $195,000. The family eventually settled in March 1988 for $96,520. He was 34 years old. R.I.P. Paul Williams.